Welcome back, guys. We're going to do a wheel bearing hub assembly on a 2017 Ram 2500 today. So you're going to start out, you got 22 millimeter to get the lugs off. We'll just rip every one of them off. Okay, and since we're here, we're using 34 millimeter for the axle nut. And then just to prep everything, we're gonna take our AIM lubricant, anywhere you'd use like a PB Blaster or WD-40. This is the stuff, and you really need to check it out. We found that it works exceptionally better, so.
That's good stuff.
We're gonna get around these, every one of these lugs, where that rotor's gonna seat on, and then around this hub right here. And I'm being extremely generous. You really don't need much of this stuff. We got some smaller bottles of it, and it works really well. Instead of like a pressurized can, you don't use near as much product. So while that's soaking in, we'll turn this wheel, use a 24 millimeter. And we're gonna get these two, I'll show you right here. We're gonna get these two caliper bracket or bolts. So one here. All right, so we pull these two caliper brackets. I just take a bungee right here, so that way when I get it off, I can hang it on there. It won't get in the way or fall down, put tension on this brake line. Another thing we're gonna do, getting ahead of myself, give yourself a little bit of a head start if you wanna pry on these brake pads just a little bit and compress the cylinder. Get just a little bit out of it so that it's not completely stuck on the rotor. Then we can buzz both of these off. You can drop everything while you're doing it. Okay, and then this should just come off. We're just gonna hang it right there so there's no tension on any of this brake line. It's just kind of hanging there. Now we're gonna take this rotor off. We've let that soak in a little bit. Sometimes you're able to move them, but a lot of times they're going to be kind of seized up, especially at this one because it's a farm truck. As you can tell, there's dirt and grime everywhere. So if you take a dead blow hammer, you really don't want to hit this with a metal hammer unless you want to put a new rotor on. You can kind of bust it up by hitting around here, but what I found is easiest is I just tap on the back here. It's moving a little bit. You can just roll it. Eventually it comes loose just like that. And you just shimmy it off. You got these four bolts that are holding this hub assembly on. You can see the studs right here, here, and then on both sides. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take some more of this AIM lubricant, same stuff, different bottle. And I'm just gonna let that soak on each one of those bolts for a minute. Let that kind of do its thing. Try and get the head of the bolts on the back here. if I can. And then while that's soaking, we're gonna go ahead and undo this ABS wire. So come a little closer. So it starts right here, and we'll leave it hooked up here. We're just gonna fish it out of this brake dust cover, all the way out of its whole harness, and then unplug it right up here off the firewall. So we'll get that knocked out. Okay, so off camera, I just moved this over here. I decided it was gonna be out of my way at the front a lot better. So this one's just got a bunch of grime in here, but once you clean all that out, you should be able to slide this wire right out from behind for that cover. And then there's just clips on this thing all the way back. You can use your hands or a screwdriver. There we go. Then you'll just pull this ABS wire all the way out. And by now we've had enough time to soak that lubricant on these hub bolts. So with those, I believe we're gonna take an 18 millimeter. Yep. Sometimes it takes a wobbly or an extension. Alright, so we end up using an extension with a wobbly. There's the bottom one. And the top one. We've got those four bolts out from right there and there on each side. Hopefully our AIM lubricants have seeped their way into this. What we're going to do is just take a hammer and we're going to hit on the back of this, and we're going to split this hub right here from the knuckle. The biggest thing here is you're going to want to make sure you're not just pulling the whole axle shaft out. So as we pull it off, we'll watch right here. If we get to where it's not going to come, there is a pulling tool we have. We can put on each side here and keep the axle in and pull it off, but we should be able to just get it off with a hammer, so we'll give it a go. Okay, so you can see the gap in it now. What I like to do from here is just work it with a pry bar. Maybe. So it's kind of popping a little bit. Okay. So you can see the hub popped out. This axle shaft has gone in, so we know we're not pulling the axle out. And we're just going to slide this off. There's your old wheel bearing hub set up. All right, we've got that old hub off. What we're going to do now is just clean this surface where this hub seals. There's a lot of corn and grime and dirt and everything. So I'm just going to take a screwdriver and make sure we get all the thick stuff out. It's going to save us a lot of hassle going back together to have this super clean. Thank you. So you get that cleaned off how you like it on this inside of those grooves. And then what I like to do is take some Scotch-Brite pad. I'm gonna clean up this surface where the bolts meet up. If you wanted, you could probably take a grinder to this carefully, but there's no need to. Then try and get in this groove. There's some rust spots up in here that are gonna keep it from going in smoothly. So you wanna get this just kinda really cleaned up. So once you've got that cleaned up how you want it, you throw a little dirt on your camera guy. You use brake clean, ether. We use a lot of ether around here. You're just gonna want to get the whole surface super clean. So here's our new hub assembly. We went with the CarQuest option, and I will link this part number down in the description, but we've had a lot of good luck with these kind of parts, so I'm not too stressed about it not being a Mopar or anything like that. So we'll get this wire untangled. And then we just got to remember that this ABS wire was at the top when we pulled that one apart. So we're gonna just start this through the splines here. Once you've got it started, lift it up. We're actually pretty close right there. And then you're just gonna take your dead blow hammer and you're just gonna, without hitting the studs, you're gonna try and tap this thing on here. You can kind of hear when bottoms out, and you can see, if you show them around that whole thing, it's flush with the knuckle. And then you're never going to get it right on unless you're perfect, so I just take this little punch, put it through the back here, and I'll just make sure I'm closely lined up with one of the holes there so we can get the bolt started with these. So this isn't something you have to do, but I went ahead and cleaned up these bolts on the wire wheel. Just got all the rust and stuff off of them so that they're a good clean thread. And we'll just start them from the back like we pulled them out. Get a few threads into each corner. Start these ones. These front ones are a little harder to get to. All right, once you got all four started, run them down with the gun. Hit them like that. Same with these back ones. Then we're going to put a torque wrench on them. They go to 149 foot-pounds. So we'll get those torqued down real quick. So we've got the hub back on, torqued down. Now we're gonna fish this ABS wire back up under the shield. Should be able to do it by hand like that. And then for now, we're just gonna tuck it over here out of the way till we're ready for it. So what we're gonna do first, we're going to set this rotor back on. And then what I like to do is just take a lug nut, spin it all the way on the bottom here. And that at least keeps it in place while we set our caliper back on. Started, and you're able to start the bottom one. There we go. All right. There's a lot of back and forth with the wheels here. Then we're going to go back to our 24 millimeter and run these caliper bolts down, just like that. Then we'll take a torque wrench to those, and it's going to torque to 260. Same on the bottom one. Okay, so now we just got to put this ABS wire back in. Comes with all new clips. You could probably reuse the old ones, but why would you if there's some new ones here? So we'll shove that down in there. We're gonna go with we've got, see how we got it. So we should be able to do that one there. Some of these, just gonna snap into those, something like that. And I had one there. Another one there. Pretty hard to see some of this, but you're just gonna snap it back in the way you took the old one out. About like that. Then you're just gonna plug this new sensor in. All right, fought that plug a little bit, but get her pushed down, push that red tab back in. Now you just run this back up and it pushes into two holes right here. Just like that. You can see right here. So now that's all tucked away how it's supposed to be. And what we've got left is an axle nut. So we're gonna set this on right now. Run it down. It's a 34 millimeter. Hit it pretty good with a gun. It's actually going to torque to 269 foot-pounds, which is kind of tough. What we're going to do is put a pry bar on this and try and hold it. So we're not going to be able to film that, or at least we might try, but we'll put a pry bar there while the other torques it to 269 foot-pounds. Okay, so we've just put a couple of the lug nuts on here so we don't damage the threads on the new hub. Let's see if we can get her torqued down. So as you can tell, hitting it with the impact gun got it there just fine. I'm sure you can probably just do that, but it's nice to be able to say you went through the proper torquing procedure. So now we're just going to throw this wheel back on, and we'll be setting that down to torque it. We probably won't show it, but those lug nuts on the front here are rated for 135 foot-pounds. I'm sure anywhere from 135 to 150 is plenty, but it is important to torque the wheel down. So thanks for watching. Hopefully we explained it all right. We're not professionals, but it's a work in progress. So we'll get this thing back on the road for the customer, and we'll see you on the next one.